If you use WordPress, chances are that you're one of the few people who are actively seeking OpenLiteSpeed or LiteSpeed Enterprise for hosting WordPress. In this video, you're going to see some of the control panels that come with OpenLiteSpeed, which will make the process of hosting your websites much easier because you won't have to do the configurations manually. I'm going to start with the free ones, and then we're going to go into the paid options. The one that you probably know and has probably used in the past is CyberPanel. CyberPanel comes with OpenLiteSpeed by default. If you're having problems with CyberPanel, you can use any of the other options that are in this list. CyberPanel has the advantage of the community. There are lots of people that use this panel. It is not perfect, but there are lots and lots of people that use it. I also use it on different servers for different clients, so I know that it is not perfect, but it works. So that's number one on the list, and it is free to use with OpenLiteSpeed. The next one is OLS Panel. This is relatively new, and it doesn't have a huge community like CyberPanel, but it is an alternative that you can use if you want to use OpenLiteSpeed and you don't want to handle the configurations yourself. Just try it and see if it will work for you. It comes with all these features here for free. And then the third option is AA Panel. Now, AA Panel works with OpenLiteSpeed, but you'll have to go to the App Center and then uninstall Nginx and then install OpenLiteSpeed. It may not be that perfect and that accurate, so just feel free to go with the others on this list. Now let's start looking at the ones that are not free, the ones that you have to pay for, the premium, the paid control panels. And at the top of this list, the one that I've used the most and can recommend is Direct Admin. Direct Admin comes with OpenLiteSpeed option. You can install OpenLiteSpeed and make it the server for, and make it the web server for all your websites. These are the prices for Direct Admin. If you're hosting for other people or you're hosting for yourself, just choose whichever plan is right for you. The next one on this list is also relatively new. It's not that new, probably 4 or 5 years old now, but it comes with OpenLiteSpeed and a bunch of all these other alternatives. So this is a next-gen control panel because the websites are hosted in containers. It doesn't use Docker anymore, but just know that your websites are virtualized in a container environment, and OpenLiteSpeed is one of the servers you can use for your website. Let's look at the pricing because that's important. So Enhance as a control panel is built for web hosting providers. That's why there's no free plan here. And the minimum monthly plan you can have is $10 per month. So that $10 can host up to 66 websites. So if you have 100, that's how much it's going to cost to host, right? So this is the price for additional websites after you reach the $10 minimum. So on a monthly basis, the minimum you have to pay is $10 a month if you're on this plan. And then as the number of websites increases, the price for each additional website also reduces. That is the pricing for Enhance. It seems to be a very promising control panel. You can test it and use it. Seems to be very reliable, good support at the moment. Let's just see how it goes, but don't be afraid to try Enhance control panel. And then the next option is Webuzo. Webuzo also comes with OpenLiteSpeed. Webuzo is created by the same people that create all these items down here. Virtualizer, Sitepad, Software Colors. So the pricing for Webuzo, let's go to the pricing. That is how much it's going to cost you. If you want to host as a business, you'll probably need to go with that, with unlimited user accounts. So it depends on whether you're hosting for yourself or you're hosting for others. If you're hosting for yourself, you can go with the one user account that, or you can go with the four user account. Let's go to the next one, which is the last one on this list. And this is Open Panel. Open Panel has a free version and an enterprise version. The enterprise version is the one that comes with OpenLiteSpeed. So if you go there under enterprise and you scroll down, you can see the features between the community edition and the enterprise edition. So if you scroll down somewhere here under web servers, you'll see that OpenLiteSpeed is not available on the community edition. It's only available on the enterprise edition, and the pricing for the enterprise edition is 149 euros per year. That is, if you pay yearly, if you pay monthly, it is roughly 15 euros per month. But it comes with unlimited websites, unlimited users, and so on. And then finally, this is just a recommendation. If you don't want to use a control panel, the one OpenLiteSpeed template that I found to be reliable and just works out of the box is the Vultra OpenLiteSpeed WordPress. And I have a video for this. You can see how to set it up. This is just you deploying your server. It will come installed with WordPress and OpenLiteSpeed SSL will be set up. I have a video that shows you how to set it up. This is best for somebody that just wants to host WordPress on OpenLiteSpeed. You don't need the other items like file manager, all the FTP servers, and everything else that comes with the control panel, like email servers. If you don't need any of that, just install this template. And if you want to send mail, you can use a WordPress plugin for sending mail using SMTP services like Mailgun, Amazon SES, and so on. That's pretty much it for alternatives for hosting WordPress with OpenLiteSpeed. Not just WordPress, but basically control panels that come with OpenLiteSpeed. So the first one was CyberPanel, and then OLS Panel, A Panel, Direct Admin, Enhance, Webuzo, and Open Panel Enterprise Edition. All right, that's pretty much it for this one. If you have any questions or you need a tutorial for each of these panels, just let me know. I can create one tutorial per video and go through all of them in a control panel tutorial series. If you need a tutorial for any of these control panels, just vote for the one that you want in the comments below. And if you want to use the Vultra OpenLiteSpeed WordPress, I'll add the tutorial below, and you can also get $300 of free credit from Vultra to test the Vultra platform. All right, that's it. Until next time.